Hello, MechWarriors! How is it going? Welcome to your daily dose of MechWarrior Online. Today, we are playing the Banshee, because some of you, one of you, put that build into my build request list on one of my streams. And I like it, I have to say. So it's cool. I modified it a little bit, a tiny, tiny little bit for a bit more heat management. So he was running a standard engine 340 and had one heatsink less. I like to run a light engine 340 and get one heatsink more so that we have a bit more heat management. Now, what are we doing? AC20 plus two Snubnose PPC is 40 damage pinpoint if you are at close range. That's nice. It's like a nice burst build. On top of it, we have ER small lasers and a triple medium laser mini laser vomit combination on top of it. So that's cool. And yeah, the Banshee 3S also has a nice thing, which is this. Wait, where is it? There. Heat minus 19%. It's crazy. So the Banshee 3S has a quirk that makes it so that your weapons generate 10% heat less. And with the skills on top of it, we now have 19% less heat generation. That means that we can fire a lot of times before we get at maximum heat threshold and need to manage our heat. That means that if you go in, burst some enemies down and then take a break to cool your mech down and then go in again and burst enemies down again, it's just so much fun to play. If you get there, of course, if you get there. Because we are running 58 kph, and we are a short range build, so positioning is crucial here. This skill build looks like that. We have invested into the firepower tree because I wanted magazine capacity. We only run 3 tons of ammo. That's not that much for an AC20. It's just enough. It's just on the edge, I would say, with magazine capacity. And then, of course, we wanted to get heat gen. There is heat gen down here and here that I'm skipping. I thought it wasn't really necessary to get these two nodes here as well. And you can get with them, you can get to 20.5% heat gen bonus. That's crazy. What I wanted is structure and armor, since we are more or less a brawler. This is very short range oriented here. No mobility, no jump jets, of course. But operations is cool because we are running a bunch of heat sinks. It's 19 in general. And therefore, cool run will really help cooling your mech down again. We have no sensors, no radar deprivation because we didn't have the points. I would really like to have that, but it wasn't possible because I favored artillery strikes and double cool shot instead. Now, this is the build, very much tilted towards survivability and firepower and DPS, like sustain. And yeah, it's a nice Banshee. So I hope you enjoy the games that are coming. And if you do, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel. And now it's time to hit the battlefield. All right, first game of the day. We are playing Rubelite Oasis and we are playing Capture the Resources, which is called Conquest in general. Now, we have some enemies at Kappa. We have Theta, and I think we're gonna set up here because at some point I believe the enemies will come to the low ground in Delta 6 into Echo 5. So we just chill here and we have our artillery ready and we also have our AC-20 ready. So, oh dear, there's a guy dropping. We have one Madcat dropping down. He's alone. Charlie. Come on, let's go. Let's kill him quickly. Okay. Oh, actually he's not that alone. Not as alone as I thought he was. But anyway, he's gonna get punished for it. I thought he was moving. Obviously, he did not. God, got that. And first cool shot for nothing. I'm pushing forward, guys. Let's get the Evan Jack as well. Forward. Okay. Dropping artillery. Oh, I cannot. Charlie on the side is a problem. I just bank on my team. Okay, they did nothing. Ooh. Hello. Sorry for the back shot. Was me. Okay, let's keep going. Pow! Crabs don't like pinpoint damage. They also don't like leg damage. And I don't like being hot. Okay, so that's escalating hard. I like it, I have to say. I really do. There's a catapult. Aim carefully. Shoot! Go for the catapult. It hit my... I'm the leg shooter today, guys. The legitimate leg shooter. Okay, but the murder ball is on. I cannot really help out with this guy, but the PPC Evan Jaguar is there. I think it is okay if I'm the only one going in there. This guy should be very hot. You see the smoke? I'm trying to get him. Am I fast enough, though? I just need an angle. Nah, he is out by now. He's gone. Damn it. Okay, I gotta turn around from here and get the high ground again. Okay, so it's 2-2 actually. can shoot the Kodiak or at least try. And I think I'm gonna stay close to the Orion here because that guy definitely needs some brawling backup. If he's only running LRMs, then of course he will be in trouble as soon as he gets pushed. Okay, Cicada in the outskirts, that's bad because I cannot catch that Cicada. I really like our murder ball situation right now. Really do. But I'm out of position. Okay. So, let's get on top again. Yeah, positioning. This is the thing, when you do not have a concrete firing line or something, you struggle getting into position with a mech. This is not good for catching somebody. I shouldn't have gone for the Evan Jack in the first place, or should have continued pursuing him. That abort in the middle of the chase there was not good. Okay, let's try to get vision. Where are the enemies? That's my biggest problem right now. I don't have anybody to shoot. There's nobody here. I think I need to drop again. I'm just right behind the cataphract. Okay, yeah, there's the cicada. He will probably pull back soon. Okay. There they are. Oh, hello. And I need to get out of this here. I have no maneuverability. So, no maneuverability means a dead Banshee in the worst case. Can we kill the Cyclops there?
Yeah.
We cannot get in over here. Oh man, positioning. I fail so hard at it right now. Let's get this Cyclops. That should have been a kill. This Cyclops is completely untouchable. And I'm dropping right in front of this guy here. How inconvenient for me. I mean, yeah, we got the side torso. We got the kill even. There goes my torso. Ah, damn it. Now I have to shut down. I was going for the kill here. And we are still too hot. The thing is, I was at maximum heat capacity when my side torso got blown off. And then I shot once more. So my heat threshold overall just shrinked to nothing. And just putting some more heat on top of it was just too much. Now my Banshee is in a very bad condition. 24%. I mean, that's still something. There was a guy at the ramp. It's 8 and 10. I'm not entirely sure if I can do anything here. It needs one shot to kill me. It's dead? Okay, nice job. Yo, Doc, do you have some armor left? My Banshee's done.
Nah. It's fine, I've got enough in the front.
There's a Cicada still on the battlefield. Okay. He's cored, though. I'm dropping artillery just there. I hope that he would pull back again. He did not. Where exactly are they? I have one artillery strike left. Are they in Delta 5?
I think he's Echo 4, actually. I thought I heard scratching, I might be wrong.
Okay, he's just right above me. Right above me. I'm dropping artillery. Okay, let's see. Got that guy.
They're both pretty wrecked.
Echo down.
But where? Where?
There's a Cyclops up where Echo just came from.
Okay, I copy that. Yeah, there's nothing I can do.
Yeah, he's smoking, but there's nothing you can do about him.
Okay. Okay, let's go in then. Last stand, guys. Last stand. This is it. I am not feeling comfortable. I'm so slow, and I have no heat threshold anymore, and I'm so crit, and my Banshee, my poor Banshee. Where did he? Ah.
CT, one touch, Black Knight.
I was trying.
You tried.
Good
game. Yeah, that was a good game. That was cool. Again, I struggled getting into position, and as a result, I was for a long time of the game, I wasn't shooting my weapons, which I should have. But anyway, in the end, it was 3 killing blows, 5 assists, 3 kill most damage dealt with 700 damage and 8 components. And that was the first round. Let's go over to the next one and see how this will go down. Alright, second game of the day. We are playing HPG Manifold and we are playing Conquest. And since we have a Mad Dog here, I shall not go to Epsilon and capture the capture point. My job is to go to the front line and I'll leave the capturing to my faster ones. So go to this space and then, you know, just let them follow up because they are faster than me. What the awesome does here is not really efficient. You shouldn't do that as an assault mech when you're starting on the side here on Conquest HPG Manifold. Anyhow, a very quick side note, since we are going to the front line and it will take a little while, a bunch of people have asked me in the comments below in my YouTube videos where the Smurfy builds are, and they have been replaced for the in-game import-export function codes. You don't see them directly because YouTube prevents me from pasting in special characters or certain special characters in the description, which makes sense, because otherwise there could be or there is a possibility of code injection, and of course they don't want any malware mark code in the malicious code in their database, of course. What I did instead is I'm using a little tool that is made for the software developers to share code between you know, them and their co-workers, which is Pastebin. Pastebin is basically just a website that is you know, just taking the code that I put in there, and it will make a permanent link that you can click. So if you're wondering where the Smurfy builds are, again, click Pastebin. That's the link down. What? That's the link down below in the description. I'm getting shot at a lot. Okay, that was not good. I was too focused on the UAV and I couldn't see the Nova behind me. All right, that was good. I mean, for my enemy team. Yeah. And the Rux. To the face. So, team. Why is there a rotation going on, and why is there an urban mech? I have no idea. Why is there everybody everywhere? Oh, crap. Okay. I'm sorry. I am mildly triggered by this. I'm pushing the basement now. Okay, we can hit the Kodiak a bunch. Pushing basement. Okay, this is not... Oh, this is gonna be very difficult. Let's try to come back from this. I really try to hit the Kodiak. This guy is scary. Very much so. Okay. Let's go. Let's just go and kill everybody. The Warhammer is a one-shot Delta. Okay, let's see if we can get an angle. We can get an angle. Hi. Uh-huh. What about you? You are running MRMs. That's devastating close range. Mm-hmm. Go away. Leave me alone. Is he dead? He's dead. Thank you very much, team. Okay, it seems that the Kodiak is dead as well. This is the thing. The catapult did the right thing. The exact right thing. He was face-hugging me to death. Why? And how did that work? MRMs are very much splash weapons. Splash weapons. And the closer you get, the lower the splash will be. Right? Does that make sense? The narrower the splash will be. He basically pointed his weapons point blank at my chest and pulled the trigger. And therefore, everything went to my CT, as you might tell here. So, I am a one-shot. I gotta position myself very, 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 very carefully now. And I want to help out here. This Timberwolf is in a bad condition as well. What's that? Medium laser Nova? Ah, this could be scary. This is actually very scary. So, I dropped artillery. So if the Timberwolf is going in, I can follow up, but I cannot really push my on my own anymore. And I'm dead. I'm not dead. I'm fine. I am actually very fine. 7-4. I mean, at least we have the caps. At least we have the advantage. Uh-huh. Am I dead now? I might be. The good thing is that they don't really... Yeah, they are not interested in me. That's good. Okay, let's go for it. Hello. Maximum risk. Maximum reward. Oh. Hi, Atlas. Thank you. Thank you, team. I shouldn't have come out alive. Okay, I'm still alive, though. So, sometimes... by the way, guys, this is why you torso twist. This is so important. Dropping from the Thanatos, I don't want any of that. This is how and why you torso twist. Okay, Thanatos is getting pushed to into my direction, but he is facing the other direction. So we go up again. Uh-huh. I want to help. Thank you. Thank you for letting me. It's 10 and 6, mistlings and... Oh, artillery, artillery, artillery. Dodged it. No. Did not dodge it. That was the last thing from the Thanatos, probably. He was, yeah, he was dropping an artillery strike. He was like, if I'm going down, I'm taking you with me. So, last one is a catapult. Let's see. It is caught already. We've got some good PPCs here. On the Nova, with medium lasers. Oh, it's a quite toasty build. I would actually drop the lasers. Alright. Oh, okay, that's not enough. Let's go for another mech. What do we have here? Katana Cat. Yeah, give him hell. Interesting build here. PPC, medium pulse, and SRM. And the catapult is just running, running, running. Because he's running LRMs, and he wants to get out of trouble. And that's the kill. Good job, Red Wolf. And, of course, everybody else. That was a very interesting game. Again, the power of the torso twist. I couldn't twist the artillery, sadly. That's just... If you can dodge a wrench, you can dodge an artillery strike. Right? No. Now, we got one killing blow, we got 9 assists, 2 kilomos damage dealt with 739 damage done and 7 components destroyed. That's the Banshee, everybody! That's the pinpoint laser build, the pinpoint burst plus laser build. And I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then don't forget to leave a rating or subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. If you want to support me, go down below to the description. There you will find the link to my Patreon page. You can get some nice rewards for that. And I hope to see you on the battlefield. Goodbye.